Where the century falls, the century of choices. If you go to your dad and mom or your grandparents, they never had a choice. They have food only on Sunday. The sweet food is available. And today at our home, we have laddu and all the sweets. We don't know what is. And they take dresses, new dresses. We make a dress. So today, choices are more. But unfortunately, the generation doesn't know how to make choices because of abundance. Abundance is more in the world today. So we have to learn how to make choices. That's why we call it as a fantastic thinker of the modern times. He says, Peter Drucker, I'll read for you. The most important event is not technology. The world is not on internet. It is for the first time in the history of human race. I repeat, it is the first time in the history of human race. Substantial and rapidly growing number of people have choice. You want to live in India or you want to live in United States of America, it's your choice. You want to be in Jaipur or you want to be in Coimbatore, it's your choice. You don't claim today, this is my birthland. People is diversified. Abundance. For the first time, they have a choice to make. They have to learn how to make choices. If you learn how to make choices, you become the most successful human today. It is to be or not to be. Yes or no. Make it or do not. And I'm forward or backward. You must have to make the choices. When everybody is sleeping on this cold morning, why are you here? Ask this question. You made a choice to be here. And today you cannot motivate people by saying something because we are in the world of millennials. You cannot motivate a millennial by saying that you work hard, you buy a Mercedes Benz. They say, I'm not interested because Ola and Uber are better than that. Right? And you say that you work hard, you buy a 4-bedroom flat in a premium property. He says that if I buy a property, then I have to pay EMI, then I have to work for it. Why should I do it? Let me go for a different property and stay for a rent. Today is the world of people are not motivated by money. People are not motivated. You go and tell these youngsters that, see, you're married, you should respect your marriage, and you see that you live together. And you know what is the slogan of today's modern world of marriage? I've lived with the same girl for the past 10 years, married 10 days ago, and divorced yesterday. That is the slogan of today. This is, they said, the God will punish you. Where is the God? Where is the God? They'll ask you. See, you feel the God everywhere. Never. If a God is good, then he would have taken care of me from that particular person who disturbed me in my life, my wife. And somebody asked him, a millionaire, what is the secret of becoming a millionaire? And he said, it's my wife. Oh, fantastic. All these days we didn't know. How is it possible? Because before marriage I was a billionaire. Before marriage I was a billionaire. Ladies and gentlemen, what I'm trying to say here is, this is the age of millionaires. You can't tell as per the words of Buddha. Buddha is like for that age, not for me. As Gandhi said, Gandhi is fantastic. I appreciate it, but I can't do that. And you say that as per spiritual verses, people say that I'm not interested. I'm an atheist. I'm a thief. Nothing like that. If I want, I'll pray. Otherwise, no. You know one thing, my dear friends. This is the world which makes a clear choice. And their choice is only motivational based on their health. You know what is the modern industry which is growing up? Health industry. You know which is the industry, which is the sport which is picking up fast? Marathon. People run every day. And you know in India there is a statistics which says that hey, there is 4 marathons happening in India, in some part of India. And people, they run for Mother's Day, they run for Father's Day, and they run for Sunday. That's a picking up sport. And our choice changed. It is not a test cricket. We play with 100 balls. 20 runs. It is 20 balls, 100 runs test. That is the change we have made. So people are so fast. And this age have to learn how to make choices. So let me start. What is choice? Let me tell you, my dear friends, choice means, as per the words of Winston Churchill, fear is a reaction, courage is a decision, and decision is a choice. Wow. Decision is a choice. It will come to a person only who has the courage, the will, right? You have the courage, you make a choice. As rightly you know the story of the first man landed on the moon, as per the request that somebody else's name is not there, and he was hesitant to do it, but the second person said, let me do it, and he became Neil Armstrong. It's a choice of courage. Choice comes by courage. Do you have a courage? That's a question. You can't even say no to your mom. It is something like a person with a lot of pampering. When we were young boys, like Vinay, right? When you are an young baby sitting and playing with the toys, you know what? Your mom is taking care of you like an angel. You know, men and women are two different entities, right? We say equality. No, they are powerful. Men are powerful, women are powerful. Right? And you know, men are made to assign to targets. Men are target-oriented. Women are process-oriented. Women are process-oriented. I'll give my example. I was traveling in a car with my wife to a marriage function. And it was around evening 4:30. And we were crossing one of the largest universities in Tamil Nadu, Girls University. And I was near the zebra crossing and it's a red light. I was so happy, it is 180 seconds. Because lots of girls are crossing. I was sitting in the car, holding the steering, watching. Keep doing it. There was a tap on my head from my authority. She asked me, what are you doing? I said, this is not my fault. It's a hereditary problem. And she asked, what is the hereditary problem? Because in those days, men went for hunting. They looked like this. Right? It's my forefather's problem. Sorry, my love, I said. She said, it's okay. Then we went to the marriage hall. They are target-oriented, men are target-oriented. And she clearly sees, why are you looking at that only pink color girl? They know the process, what we are doing. Right? Which one you mean? The girl who is in the tall? That's what I'm saying. We are target-oriented, guys. Right? And we went to the marriage. And as you know, when a man accompanies the wife to the marriage hall, we have only two jobs, eat and smile. Right? Eat, wait, smile. And she'll be talking, we'll be guardians. And I also did that. I'm a good husband. Right? I did that. And she was speaking to an auntie. After the speech, she turned up to me and with a frown face, she said, did you saw the jewelry? What is it? This is all fake gold. This is all fake gold. And I asked, you mean that auntie's jewelry? No, no, no. The lady standing at the corner of the hall. She's speaking to the lady here and looking at the lady at the corner of the hall. Multiple intelligence. And I said, I didn't notice. What you will notice in your life? Good for nothing. You may win a Nobel Prize. You may become a national president. You go and ask my wife, he will say, he doesn't know even to buy brinja. Right? She has a list of complaints. So she said, that you don't know anything, how you become national president? Is it a crime? I didn't notice. Right? She says that you didn't notice that. I didn't notice, mom. Right? And we came back home. What I'm saying is, women do multitasking.
Yes. Yes.
Women do?
Multitask.
Men are target-oriented, result-oriented. And coming back to Vinay. Vinay is here playing, right, with the toys. And his father comes to Vinay
And he said, "Brother, Papa, say bye to Papa."
And then I said, "Papa, bye." And Father goes to the office. Mommy is cooking. Vina is playing. And she's cooking. And you know what? When the women is cooking, the mega civil is on in the second door. And they listen to the mega civil. Listening to mega civil, cooking and looking at Vinay playing. Three jobs at the same time. At the same time, washing the utensils, the fourth job. And the fifth job, mobile phones here. And still, utensils are washed, cooking is done, listening to mega serial, looking at Vinay. Hello? Yes. You all agree? Yes. You all say hi. Hello?
Hi.
You all agree?
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
Great. So Vinay was enjoying it. You look at Vinay, the guy who introduced me, is well built. He has a very good habit. Whatever lying on the floor, he will eat. You can check with him the size, right? He will eat. So Vinay was used to it. And there is a cockroach coming in. And Vinay caught it. You know what is the next job? Put it in the
mouth.
He was enjoying the cockroach. Playing with the cockroach. Hands full of cockroach. And here, mom is cooking. Utensils washing. Listening to mega serials, answering in the speaker phone now. And the moment she turned this side, the sun here is with
cockroach.
Cockroach. And mom is in this place. She turned and said, No, put up, man. That fellow looked at first time a devil in life. At the age of two. Right? Can you tell me from this place to this place, how many no's I said? Five? Ten?
Six?
40? Ladies and gentlemen, that is countless. In our life, the no's are more than the yes's. Your mom started with a no, your father said no, your mother said no, your brother said no, sister said no, and you're fired like a commander. No. Black said no. Washing, no. Let me play in the rain, no. I love that girl, no. They said no for a love. That day this fellow stopped loving women. And he married, and what happened, you know. Right? Everything is a no. And we are built up and groomed in the world of no's. We have to clutch this no's and we have to learn the choice of saying yes. When you said, "I want to wear the black dress today," there was a no. When you said that, "Let me become a national president," the world said no. It's not possible. You know what? What? You speak well, that's why it's not possible. And they say, "Mr. Ramesh, it's not possible." What? You don't speak, that's why it's not possible. Because people love to say no. And we get so much of no's, and I tell you, my dear friends, courage is saying yes. No matter what, you say yes, that's called courage. You know what is the result of courage? Either you fail or you win. You fail. Fail like Adolf Hitler. Who lost World War II? Who lost World War II? Adolf Hitler. Who won World War II? Any idea? Winston Churchill. People don't remember winners. People remember those who do big. You lose World War. Learn the history book. Rana said, "You kill, don't kill one person, kill thousands. You are being escorted by CPR." I love Vijay Malaya in this case. You take loan, don't take 10,000 rupees, take 10,000 crores. The Prime Minister says, "Please come to India," and this fellow says, "Sorry, sir, I'm in India, Pakistan matches. I'm busy in watching matches." That's the big thinking about taking loan. That's courage. You must learn courage. What is choice? It is a fearless reaction, and courage is a decision. Do what is right, not what is easy is choice. Right? Do what is right and not what is easy is choice. Doing right is difficult. Easy is something very comfortable. Right? You know what is doing right? Breaking your own records is called doing right. You don't have any competitor in the world except one. That's you. You learn the art of beating your own self. Right? You can compromise with anybody in the world. I tell you, my dear friends. Ladies and gentlemen, hello.
Hi.
I'm not getting high. Hello.
Hi.
That's great. You can compromise with anybody in the world. You can even compromise with the beggar in the world. You can compromise with your wife. You compromise with your husband. You compromise with your in-laws. You compromise with the cheapest guy, the weakest guy, and an irrelevant politician. You compromise with a criminal. I said you can even compromise within a criminal, within a beggar. But one person you should not compromise. You know who is that?
Yourself.
Yourself. Right? If somebody is spitting on me, that's it, over. But you can't spit like that. It falls on your face. Hello?
Hi.
Follow me?
Yes.
Please understand, my dear friends, that's God doing right, not doing
easy.
And I can tell you, a mistake repeated more than once is called a choice. A mistake repeated more than once is called choice. Do you know the original spelling of Google? Let me ask before that, who is the CEO of Google? Louder and clear. Hello? Hello? Well, who is the CEO of Google? Anyone, please tell me who is the founder of Google? Yes. One or two answers, the founders. This is India. We are excited to be in a great labor. Hello? Sundar Pichai is labor. Only his salary is big. Hello? Follow me?
Yes.
I'll tell you, my dear friends, this Larry Page, the founder of a Google, came with a different spelling. But the moment he went for the presentation, he saw that the spelling mistake is there, a typographical error, which says G-O-O-G-L-E. And he said, ladies and gentlemen and my dear friends, I'm launching a new company called in a search engine, Google. Spelling is mistake. But when he turned here, he said, that's Google, right? He said, and after the presentation, he came back and his co-founder said, I'm sorry, Larry, it's a mistake by me. The next time onwards, I'll correct the mistake. You know what Larry Page said? Don't worry, my dear friends. Give me 5 years. I see that the spelling mistake is... People say, I say it's possible. That's called choice. What is choice? No excuses. Choice is no excuses. You can't have excuses. That's called choice.
Right.
No excuses. My father is poor. We are Lincoln. Right? I'm not, my parents are not athletes. You are in the same boat. My father doesn't know cover drive. You got Sachin Tendulkar. I'm not born to a family which is made up of great fortune. You will not have Dhirubhai Ambani. No excuses. You learn giving excuses. That's the end of you. And you learn excuses from mega series. You want to learn excuses, go and watch mega series. Choice is no excuse. And choice is, this is perfect answer for choice. Perfectly imperfect. For the first time, people say it will not work. People say it's not possible. It is imperfect. And imperfection becomes perfection when you consistently, persistently learn the art of making choice. Right? And what is choice? It's a perspective. When somebody sees, it's like somebody goes to a Guruji and says that, Guruji, I am suffering from a headache. Please help me how to solve out of this problem. I went to allopathy, I went to the best of best doctors, but nothing worked out. You have to tell me how to solve this problem. Guruji said, it's so simple, my dear son. You watch green colors, your problem is solved. And this fellow went home, a very rich guy, changed his walls into green color, floors into green color, ceiling into green color, curtain into green color, wife into green color, children into green color, and his headache is gone. Happy living. One day Guruji came in a saffron dress. The watchman said, you can't go change your dressing room. He told people, you're not allowed. But this fellow said, what your nonsense speaking? Call your watchman. The boss ran and came, sorry sir, please come, Guruji, Guruji. And he went in, what nonsense you have done, mister? What sir, you asked me to look at the green colors and I'm looking at the green colors, all my problems are solved. What's wrong with it, sir? And he said that you stupid, instead of changing the whole world into green, you would have worn and a green color spectacle, everything looks green. Wow. That's called perspective, ladies and gentlemen. It is inside out. I repeat, it is inside out. Your cooking is good, you will have an exhaust fan working. Hello?
Hi.
Only if you cook, you use exhaust fan. Yes or no?
Yes.
If you are not cooking, no exhaust fan. Yes?
Yes.
So productivity gives exhausts. Productivity goes to the world. And inspiration goes to the world. Your perspective is all coming from inside out. That's why they have an exhaust fan in the cooking. Hello?
Hi.
That's what we call it as a perspective. And the next point I can say that. Adaptability. Hello?
Hi.
You start. Let's start. And this we call it a sinner choice. But my subject is to say a little more. How to make choices. People say what choice. But it's very important you learn how to make choice. We know what are the choices. Red is there, blue is there, green is there. But you have to learn how to make choices. I got a manual for you to make choices. You want to know that?
Yes.
No, I'm not excited about it. You want to know that?
Yes.
I'm not excited on that side. You want to know that?
Yes.
No, the world is not listening. Do you want to know that?
Yes.
That's right, my dear friends. The first one is the world in your life. There is some time is called as my time. You know what is my time? The time meant for me. The time in which I sit and think for me. The time which is spent for me. The time I find the, my heart and the soul and the mind in one line. How many of you have a mind time every day? Seriously?
Yes.
You are reading books is not my time. Watching TV is not my time. Walking is not my time. Sleeping is not my time. Reading is not my time. Eating is not my time. Thinking is not my time. Tell me, how many of you have my time? You know what is my time? Doing nothing and sitting is called my time. Nothing. Just sit. I'll tell you, today's world, the greatest intruder is not Adolf Hitler. Adolf Hitler conquered only 80% of the world. Alexander conquered 90% of the world. WhatsApp conquered the toilets of the world. Even to your private place of your toilets. And some fellow says that, sir, I'm not suffering from constipation. Why? My mom says, no WhatsApp in the toilet. Right, my dear friends, you don't live without technology. You don't live without WhatsApp. I'm not against it. We don't have a mind time. We are connected and we are engaged and we are impacted by the external influence. We don't have mind time. My time is a time in which I'm idle and it's for me. You go to a temple and you pray, it's not my time. Hello?
Hi.
You go to a temple and pray, it's not your my time. You sit quiet in the temple and just listen to your voice. That's my time. Tell me only about my time. Oh, really? That's great. And this is a part of a life, right? And number two, a ritual. You know what is ritual? You know what is ritual, everybody? Giving in the right hand is right, or giving in the left hand is right. Right hand, that's a ritual. Every day morning you brush teeth and take bath, or take bath and brush teeth. That's a ritual. Who saw, who told, which doctor told? Which manual says? You brush teeth, you take bath and brush teeth. No problem. Right? And nobody knows, we spend lot of time in rituals. And you open your stock, shop open 100 times and in one direction 65 degrees you do this, right? That's a ritual. Hello?
Hi.
You are with me? That's a ritual. You spend lots of time in ritual and we don't know why we do it, but still you do it because you model somebody. That's called ritual and you spend time on it. And N stands for nice entertainments. You know what? We are engaged.
we are networked and we are wounded and we are being connected and you can't escape. Entertainments. We love entertainments. You know what is entertainments? Any examples of entertainment, anybody? Yes.
Listening to music.
Music is entertainment, anybody? I'm sorry. Dancing is entertainment. Anybody else? Yes, sorry. Spending time with children is entertainment. Sport is an entertainment. Painting is entertainment. Friends, hanging out with friends is entertainment. Watching television is entertainment. WhatsApping is entertainment. Facebooking is entertainment. Quitting is entertainment. Hello?
Hi.
How many crores you made out of quitting? Nobody. How many lakhs you made out of WhatsApping? Nobody. Right? And this, we call it as an entertainment. And that's the fourth category we call it as your ego games. Right? Your ego. India wants to know. Who says this? That's the ego game. We love to listen to what India wants to know. Tomorrow India holiday or working day. Right? A discussion. According to the expert from the Jawaharlal Nehru University. Sir, what's the point? See, tomorrow is supposed to be a holiday. No, please stop. Let's come to this one. What's happening? Hello?
Hi.
You all agree?
Yes.
Your ego games. Right? And you know what? My father comes home and I say, Pranam, father, how are you? Why don't you have a breakfast? I'm rushing to the office. And he says, don't worry, beta, you please take care. I'll take breakfast and go. And I come back home, my wife will be in a tough face. Yesterday my mom came. Did you ask this? Hello?
Hi.
You all with me?
Yes.
It's ego game. That's a ego game. Right? You all with me what I'm trying to say? I like and dislike is an ego game. Is good or bad is an ego game. And you know what, my dear friends, the statistic says that the whole life, 99% of a human life is based on ego games. You don't do business for you, you do it for your competitor. You don't wear your dress for you, you do it for your competitor. You don't buy this car for you, you do it because your brother-in-law bought it. It's an ego game. Absolutely ego game. And I'll tell you the fifth point, an intimacy, a love time. How many of you kissed your wife? When? See, I'm sorry, only four guys are raising. And others are coming, sir, we are in Jaipur. Don't get excited and try to attempt it here. I'm telling you, an intimacy time, a time of great quality with love. And finally, I can say that the love productivity. You should love productivity. You know what is productivity? Hello? I tell you, my dear friends, you spend your mind time to improve yourself, that's called productivity. You break your rituals to improve yourself, it's called productivity. You listen to entertainments and music and you feel happy and excited, that's called productivity. And you play ego games to win in your career, that's called productivity. And you love your children and family and the society grows and you grow, that's called productivity. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you how to make choice. Avoid the first five or carry all the first five towards six. Choice. You do ego games for your productivity, it is a choice. You do intimacy for your productivity, it's your choice. You do things where you grow or you break your own record. That is called making choices. This is the manual of making choices. And that is, you say, hanging out with a friend, entertainment. You hang with your friend and you will improve your business. That's called productivity. You quit and you bring customers, that's called productivity. You use your FaceTime and talk to your wife and sisters and brothers and they are happy, that's called productivity. I have a My Family WhatsApp group of 620 people and we exchange all good stuff. Today I went to Jaipur and met somebody. Do you like to have something? That's called productivity. My wife is happy, I'm happy, family is happy. That's called productivity. Your ego games. Somebody comes and says that this is not possible. Convince him with your ego games. happy, I'm happy. That's called productivity. Intimacy, hanging with friends and calling. How many of you have best friends? Wow. How many of you have more than one best friends? Lots of people. For your information, best friend can be only one. And you know what? A study was done in Yale University in the Department of Psychology. And they say that 1 out of 10,000 people have best friends. Others have only friends. And many have only colleagues. You know who is the best friend? You know who is the best friend? You share something with her. Sharing and caring. You take yourself to them. When you are troubled, they are there. No. They are not best friends. You know who is a best friend? A best friend is somebody who listens to your nonsense with all senses. Who listens to your nonsense with all senses. Today morning I was listening to an powerhouse by BNP Subramanian. Huh? It's too good. It was something. Still the message is not shared. Wow. And you know why people have pet animals, dog and cat at home and parrots? Nobody listens to them. That's why at least a dog will listen to them. Like five dogs means none of them in the lake are listening. So they want a dog, so that the dog says, Tony, go ahead. I'm happy, man. Dog listens to me. Tony, come here. Sit down. Tony obeys me. Ladies and gentlemen, we are lacking. We are craving for it, quest for it, thirst for it. Somebody will listen to us. Why changing government? Because the government didn't listen to you. Changes should be made only in limited edition. After this conference, go home and say that you are not listening, I'm changing you. You can't do that. So,
hi.
You all with me?
Yes.
That's my difference. That's why I call it this. When you convert all this why into six, and if it gives productivity, that's called choice. So,
hi.
That's why millennial says that I don't want Mercedes. You buy Mercedes for 50 lakhs, you have a driver for 15,000, and maintenance of 10,000, and a petrol for every day 5,000. Cost is waste. Let me hire an Uber. No parking problem. No driver problem. No problem in life.
Productivity. Hi.
Yes or no?
Yes.
And you download a WhatsApp. Jio is getting money. You watch a Facebook. Facebook getting the money. In the entertainment industry become productivity. Hello?
Hi.
I'll tell you, my dear friends, when you go for a jogging, you know people go for jogging and they come back without sweating. They go for a jogging, come back without sweating because everyday exercise is good for them. Somebody said, you know what? People join health gym and 90% of the people never exceed more than a week in a health gym. And in the remaining 10%, 5% never comes up even for the first day. And the last 5%, no other go. The doctor said, if you are not working, you will die 10 days ago. Right? No productivity there. Ladies and gentlemen, I tell you, this is the manual. Make your mind time into productivity, ritual into productivity, entertainment into productivity, ego game into productivity, and intimacy into productivity. And to say, in the year 2019, what is your choice? Hello?
Hi.
What's your choice? Any one word. Can anybody say? Fantastic. Productivity. You wear your dress to grow. You talk with people to grow. You think to grow. You attend conferences to grow. You attend meetings to grow. You eat to be healthy. You read books to be thinking better. And have friends to be loving. And develop your relationship. Develop your health. Develop your social life and be happy in your life. I call it as my dear friends, that's called leadership. Choice is leadership. People are followers of the leaders. 80-20, the golden rule of the world. 80% are followers, 20% are leaders. 80% are rich, 20% are, 80% are poor, 20% of the rich. People asked me when during my national president visit, why very few people join JCC? Because we belong to 20%. We belong to 20%. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make a choice not to be led, led to be lead and become a leader so that we develop a leadership. And we call this with the last statement. If we want to make everyone happy, hello?
Hi.
Better go sell ice cream. If you want to make everyone happy, better go sell ice cream. Leadership is not making everybody happy. It is making happiness contagious. Let the year 2019 be happier for you with a courageous, determined, productive year of 2019. Next convention, we'll meet again and you say, sir, I've grown in my health, wealth, social life, spiritual life, and family life. If that is done, this is done. On dot 10 o'clock. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, sir.
That was a real, real powerful session in this morning powerhouse. So, to facilitate Dr. Chief Subramanian, I would invite National Treasurer J.C. Nitesh Sethia. Sir, please. To go to me. And thank you all for being such a wonderful audience. Thank you.